Now, I would like to call upon Professor Suraj Boyo, sir, for his session on evaluation on IP. He has initiated entrepreneurship awareness and development in various institutes across Pune. Currently, he is working as a university manager with MIT ADT University.
Thank you, Vaishno. So I hope, I don't know how many of you have skipped your lunch, but I am happy to see you because, and during these deliberations, let me compliment you as well. So before getting into the, because I also don't have that much time to cover, but those who are in campus and those who are not in this campus, they can definitely get back to me for any sort of help. The person who risks nothing, does nothing, has nothing, is nothing, right? And earlier speaker has also told you the importance of startup and entrepreneurship and other thing. That's the area where I also work from last 6 years. I have been doing a lot of promotional activities for the same. So as we discussed earlier as well, everything starts with an idea. And for me, idea is acronym for imagine, develop, design, market and solution. So these are the steps for any kind of idea, you can see. So I have given you a challenge for the product and other thing. But let me tell you, if you are really looking forward to take your idea as a startup or anything else, most importantly, you need to focus on value proposition. Because value proposition is the only attribute which connects customer and the service provider. Now it's up to you how you have communication channel and distribution channel to reach your customers, how customer could get back to you if he or she requires product or services which you would offer, and management of resources becomes key ingredient of your all this startup masala. So before getting into this, lot of deliberations have already conducted on copyright, patents, trademark, GIs, okay? So we will not go into that, but this is a quick exercise for you. This is the patent of US, which has been granted in 1936. Can you imagine what is this? There it has been written. Do you know the inventor? That is the sign of the attorney, US Patent Office. But you will be shocked to know the inventor, right? Next. So there are some patents. This patent has been referred as celebrity patent because as Einstein, he has not worked as an inventor because he has given famous equation of E is equal to mc squares, right? But this, he has obtained patent in it. Design for a blouse, okay, which can fit to healthy wear as well as slimmer one as well. So if you go through when it has been and for how many period, how much time, it has been clearly mentioned. Term of patent, 3.5 years. So it is the case of 1936. Nowadays it has been very much clear and transparent. Okay. So you just go through it. To all whom it may concern, be it known that I, Albert Einstein, a citizen of German Republic, residing in borough of Manhattan, country of New York, state of New York, have invented new original. So this kind of disclaimer, inventor has to give. Okay. Next. So this is just a quick exercise because I don't have time because I need to take presentation as well. So now this answer you need to record as a group and then we will assess. We will discuss on it. Next. So question number one, which item would be able to patent? Okay, let's see how much you understood. How many of you go with option number A? Option A? No one? Option B? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So option B for 6. Then option C. बार बार हाथ नहीं उठाना है. ओके एंड ऑप्शन डी 1, 2, 3, 4. ओके दिव्या मैम इज स्टिल हियर. ठीक है, बेइज्जती मत कराओ. सो यू जस्ट रिकॉल विच आइटम वुड यू बी एबल टू पेटेंट. ऑलरेडी वी डिस्कस्ड टेस्ट, 3 क्राइटेरियाज, राइट. सो दोज हु सेड अ साइंटिफिक और मैथमेटिकल डिस्कवरी और थ्योरी, कैन यू जस्टिफाई?
सर,
यस, बट इफ यू कुड रिकॉल वन ऑफ द रिसोर्स पर्सन हैज ऑलरेडी मेंशन्ड अबाउट सेक्शन 3. Right, so if you just go through section 3, section 3, invention those who are not patentable. Then section 4 deal with the atomic energy and origin. That is again different thing. So right answer is C. Okay, so those who are not on the same page, please recall. Okay, and after this we will have question answer session, as well as I will let you know what to be done in the coming days and for your future career as well. Then second question, identify true or false. Registration is a requirement for copyright protection. Okay. Depend.
Yes sir, yesterday when we discussed about this, it was said that it is not mandatory to have a registration. But if you need
it is advisable. Will help
you. Yeah, but you need to comprehend question. First, you have to be good listener. Registration is a requirement for copyright protection.
False.
So, true or false?
False.
True. Can you justify how it would be true?
Because for acquiring a copyright, first you need to make an application where you get the copyright and number and all those things. That would be the one which will give you copyright protection. Registration is the first step in acquiring a copyright.
So if someone don't registers copyright, he or she don't have right over it?
Legal right. I'm asking a paper which is certified by the government that so and so ID has been protected by copyright for this person. And if you are writing on a simple A4 paper, that doesn't make any sense.
So let's take an example of A.R. Rahman concert.
His songs are copyrighted by
A.R. How?
He has protection because
how? He is performing that song first time for the public. Then वो गाना गाएगा या फिर copyright का application बनाएगा? Yes or no? Think of it. Or suppose if you would like to write some kind of poem or something and you would like to get it published. So do newspaper article or any magazine will ask you, भैया पहले आपका कॉपीराइट का सर्टिफिकेशन दिखाइए, देन ओनली वी विल पुट योर नेम. नो, सो इट इज एडवाइजेबल टू सीक प्रोटेक्शन एंड अदर थिंग, बट इट इज नॉट अ रिक्वायरमेंट, इट इज नॉट मैंडेटरी टर्म.
कॉपीराइट कम्स इनटू एक्जिस्टेंस द मिनट यू एक्सप्रेस्ड योर
आइडिया. यस, एंड यू हैव होल सोल. लाइक एज शी ऑल्सो मेंशन ड्यूरिंग मॉर्निंग सेशन, लाइक मिस्टर विकास हैज बीन क्लिकिंग फोटोज फॉर दिस सेशन. But that becomes property. Why? Because camera equipment and other equipments have been property of the university. So it becomes copyright of the university.
Even if he uses his own DSLR, still it's the property of the university because he's a student with the university.
So suppose if you are flying through some private jet and if you are clicking some aerial photo, like aapko pata hoga, there are several coffee table books of Wari, like Uddhav Thackeray and other does, but they can't see copyright on it. Because of all these litigations, okay? So next question. What types of works are protected by copyright? Are you sure?
Yes.
Any other option? Okay, great. Next. Which of these is a geographical indication? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. हैरी पॉटर का कौन है फैन? तो व्हाट इज द आंसर? इवन आई हैव टोल्ड यू लास्ट डे एंड शी हैज आल्सो टोल्ड यू शैंपेन. ओके, देन व्हाट डज अ ट्रेडमार्क प्रोटेक्ट? ए कितने लोगों का है? नो. बी सी आप व्हाट्स योर आंसर? डी द लुक शेप एंड फील ऑफ अ प्रोडक्ट. ओके, द राइट आंसर इज ओके. देन 6, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज एन इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी एज पर आईपीआर लॉज इन इंडिया? हाउ सुयश, व्हाट इज द आंसर? कैसे क्या भाई?
सर, बिकॉज ओरिजिनल लिटरेरी वर्क इटसेल्फ इज अ कॉपीराइट वर्क.
इट कुड बी कॉपीराइटेड, इट कुड बी प्रोटेक्टेड अंडर कॉपीराइट प्रोटेक्शन.
एंड देन सेकंड, इंडस्ट्रियल डिजाइन और ऑफ मारुति 800 का. सो इस ओनली मारुति कंपनी हैज दैट राइट टू मेक दैट कार. सो इट कम अंडर डिजाइन प्रोटेक्शन.
ठीक है.
And then trademark of Tata company, no one can steal or no one can go.
अगर मैं trademark of Torque Motors कर दूँ तो Torque Motorcycles, then it would be okay.
तो भी answer all of the above
is there. Okay. So, okay. Yes. अभी ये थोड़ा tricky है. Let's see. So these are all true or false. So this is generally we used to do even in lectures as well, whether you have understood or not the level. So custom authorities has no role in enforcement of intellectual property rights. Is it true or false? Abbas, justify how it could be true. Customs authorities has no role in enforcement. नहीं तो फिर अभी मुझे I need to contact Ritika. So is it? Great. Next, custom laws empower customs officers to take action against IPR infringing goods at the time of import. Any confusion? So it's true, they can. It is responsibility of custom officers to seize infringing goods at the time of import, even if the IPR right holder is not interested in enforcing his IPR. Sure. कितने लोगों को अभी भी confusion है? कुछ लोग जवाब ही नहीं दे रहे. None of the above. Or it depends. एकदम हाँ. What is the right answer?
False.
Do you know the famous case? आप सभी को dual sim पता है. Everyone uses dual sim phone. But the first patent granted for dual sim is from India. अगर आपको नहीं पता है तो ठीक है, भले ही फ़ोन हमने नहीं, मतलब स्मार्टफोन ऑब्वियसली वी हैव नॉट इन्वेंटेड, बट द dual sim concept. So that is really interesting case study. अभी उसमें time जाएगा, but you can Google it. How he stopped shipment of other phones because of the royalty issues and other thing. Import वगैरह सब रुक गया था because of the issue. Then next, custom holders normally takes action against infringing goods at the initiative of right holder. धीरे धीरे अभी आवाज़ कम होती जा रहा है.
right holder.
False.
See, as we have seen earlier as well, customs can still like put a stay on it, like do not go from the port. But action will be taken when action is already taken. Sorry, the action is already taken that he has stopped it right there. The original owner didn't call him and tell him we stop it. It's come, some infringing goods are coming. The owner doesn't even know that some infringing product is coming, but customs stopped it right there and there. And after that, it was informed to him that this is the case. What should be the further action?
Great. Let's have a big round of applause for him. So the answer is false. Okay. Then it is only the right holder who can tell the officer as to whether the particular imported goods are infringing or not. See, I have been taking this intentionally because enforcement has a lot of problems right now in our India. In our country, right? Because we are not that law-abiding citizen. Till date.
False.
It's true.
The custom officer can see.
आपने जवाब दिया है उस true का पहले. Now you are getting confused.
After the court case, it will be decided na, if really it's not, because uska doubt was he can stop the consignment.
Same thing, you can file FIR for against anything, anyone else.
Yes.
That is first information report, right? Then they start.
Innocent until guilty.
But only the right holder can say it's infringement or not. Na. Earlier, the custom ne bol ke usko ruka to diya na.
See, what's the question? Ruka diya based on the question.
Okay. Next. Ah.
Can you please define what is the right holder? Is it the
owner? Owner of the IP.
Patentee in case of patent.
Copyright owner. Jisne kitab likhi uska author. Jisne publish kiya wo publisher. Right holder. Jiska rights hota hai in that IP.
Okay. Last two questions. Why an invention should be patented? So this will cover your justification, why you would like to seek IP protection for your IP and why is it necessary. All. See, I will read for you. It gives protection to a patentable invention. It gives in protection to patentable innovation or that right holder. It gives protection to whom?
Right
holder. So pahla to kat gaya. Then second, it gives legal recognition to the invention. Theek hai, ho sakta hai. It makes others aware of the fact as to whom does the invention belong. That's why we file IP. Ki mujhe ise batana hai ki ye mera hai. Are you sure? Why? Are, it's not like that. Even if you recall, first days, Janak Singh has also mentioned, most of the times, just to file the patent and other thing, we actually lose the charisma of that invention. How? We just get it filed. And when, if someone takes follow-up, industrial use bhi dikha denge, justify during interview and other thing. But if you can't commercialize your IP, because the third most important is industrial utility. If no one is using your invented or patent, that's not the use. I say bahut sare pani puri vending machine or yes, they got the patent, but no one is using that.
But they should know it belongs to the IP seller.
Yeah, anyway, they can know this. Why? Until and unless they don't go for patent search and other thing, they will not understand it. Theek hai, but that is not main thing na. दैट इज नॉट द मेन रीजन, दैट्स वाई यू शैल पेटेंट इट. मुझे बस बाजू वाले को बताना है, दैट्स वाई आई एम पेटेंटिंग. इट्स नॉट द राइट वन ऑफ, इट कुड बी बट नॉट प्राइमरी रीजन. वॉट विच वन? हाँ, इट गिव्स प्रोटेक्शन टू ओनर, नॉट द पेटेंट इन्वेंटेड, यू नो. Yes, that's why ISA and IPA comes into picture. See, even Indian Patent Office would not just grant you the patent. They will do their own prior art and other things, right? And patenting one's invention make useful data relating to the invention available to other invention for further R&D. So which one is the right one? B is the right one, because it gives you legal protection. You can fight, actually, you can sue, you can file infringement suit against that defaulter. Then next, a policy or policies behind the patent system is, aaj hi baat hui policy pe. So what is the right answer? Is it to encourage an inventor to disclose an invention by granting exclusive rights over the invention to the inventor? Or to benefit the public by limiting the scope and term of the exclusive rights granted to an inventor? To benefit the public through encouraging innovation by publishing a full disclosure of the technical details? Or to benefit the public through guaranteeing that the inventor can commercialize his or her invention? All of them. All the options are correct. Okay? That's how policy has to be in place. Okay? Next. Okay, this is just a small video because startup ka bahut sara baat ho raha tha aur abhi bhi hone wala hai. Right? So, just for a lighter moment. स्क्रीन बड़ा करूँ.
ओके, आई एम बोर्ड.
आवाज़.
आई हैव एन आइडिया.
व्हाट
डिड यू जस्ट से? आई हैव एन आइडिया. Anyway, so I was talking about...
Wait!
So basically, he has an idea. Thank you.
Amazing. Here is $30 million.
How about $40
million? $60 million.
I think we have a deal.
But I haven't even told you my...
See, guys. $1 billion isn't cool.
No, it's not cool.
You know what's cool?
What's cool?
$1 billion that you don't deserve.
What?
Yes. And can I just tell you that you were the inspiration behind us starting The Bubble?
Obviously.
Our startup is known as The Bubble?
Yeah.
Hey, add a the.
Oh, yes, yes.
The.
Oh,
that's so smart.
The Bubble.
Okay. Yes.
That's amazing.
Okay, listen, at least listen to
How do you like our startup's new office?
This is a hill.
Yep. Next round of funding just came through. Thought it's time to expand.
You buy a hill? Okay, listen, I'm not getting how you or anybody is going ahead.
Listen, I need to take this. Hey, we need more money, Mike.
Well, because I bought a hill, Mike.
Okay, we need to... Well, you tell him that his valuation is bullshit. We're a $1 trillion startup, Mike. What? Sorry, people, right?
Okay, how did you manage to get this? I'm a little confused. I don't understand
what's going on. Okay.
See, this is because you're the practical guy, but I'm the visionary. You're Steve Woz, and I'm Steve Jobs.
But we don't make anything or we don't do anything.
But that's just how things work now. People give you money, and then you spend the money, and then they give you more money. It's great. Capitalism.
That's not how capitalism works.
Hey, let me do my Steve job, okay? God damn it, Mike!
What is going on?
We're celebrating.
What are you celebrating?
Milestone.
What milestone?
I don't even know.
Okay, listen, I'm getting a little worried about the way that you've been spending the money.
Don't worry, just do your Steve job, man.
Okay, stop saying that.
Wow, dude. All right, word.
Okay, how are people paying you more money to do nothing?
Well, no, it's obvious. It's mass hysteria and it's always worked out well in the past.
Okay, Kanan, bro.
Yeah.
Friend.
Yeah.
For the love of God, just listen to my idea.
Oh, no, I see how it is. My idea, right? My idea. My idea. My. Me. What about the Steve job that I am doing?
What are you doing?
Wow. You're gonna hear from my lawyer.
I'm afraid your friend is suing you for $1 billion.
What? What is he suing me for?
$1 billion.
I know that. But for what?
$1 billion.
I know, but what for?
Huh, oh. $1 billion.
I know the figure, but what is the reason?
It's a song by Hoobastank.
What is the reason he is suing me?
Is that a new song? Yeah, I haven't heard that.
That's it. Keep everything. It doesn't matter. I don't want anything.
No, you
want
sir, to... just...
Shut up! Just shut up! Shut up!
I just wanted to apologize. You were right about this whole startup game.
I actually didn't say anything.
You know, it's just a bunch of people creating value to fail spectacularly.
I never said that particular thing at all either, so don't.
I really should have listened to you.
You're not listening to me now.
You know, can we be friends?
Come on.
Fuck it.
Yes. Just out of curiosity though, so you had to shut down the company because we did nothing, right? We didn't make anything.
Oh no, I sold it to Facebook.
Fuck it. Fuck it.
What?
Fuck it. Fuck. Good.
What?
So, this is how what actually happens in real life, right? So you just start with an idea, but you don't know how to get it. Like if I ask the question, who would like to be entrepreneur or who would like to be more successful, everyone will raise the hand. Or there are some students also, those every time I approach, sir, kuch karna hai, kya karna hai, wo nahi pata, kuch karna hai, apna kuch chalu karna hai, yeah, we need to have some startup, because now startup word has become that kind of buzzword and hashtag even, to put it on your Insta or any account, right? So it's not like that. It's not that easy because you need to play all the roles, right? And for that, even Dr. Mohit Dubey will definitely let you know how exactly. That's how I have invited now. When you will be showcasing your idea, he will be also judging you whether is it possible, feasible or not. And there you will take the new next. Next. So, because lot of amongst you has approach and because you don't know what to do, so this slide is basically for you, because after this workshop, what else could be done, and there could be question mark on your faces as well, ki kya iske baad kya, next step kya hoga. So, I will ask everyone, complete DL 101 course, which is free of cost, okay, through WIPO Academy. And they will provide you certificate as well, online certificate. And that's how you can create your interest, whether to go in patents, copyrights, trademarks, or GI and other IPs. Then be updated with ipindia.nic.in. Why? Because 2 days back only, yesterday only, they have revised the fees on 16th, first day of our workshop. They have reduced patent filing fees to 60%. Now can you imagine? So that much reduction just to sensitize regarding IPs. And then go through acts, rules, manuals, and guidelines provided by CGPDTM, Controller General of Patent, Design, and Trademarks. And these are some top IP blocks which you can definitely, spicy IP is most active, but we have lost one of its important key person in India, Shamnath Bashir, who made accident last month and died unfortunately. He was very much active amongst for, and he was activist for IP awareness, you can say. So these are several, this I am going to share with you, don't worry. Next. Then another thing, there are several courses available online as well through Swayam and NPTEL platform regarding patents, even for patent examination, because most of you even ask about how to prepare for patent agent examination. So that you can do online. Then try to attend WIPO Summer School 2020. Every year, RG and IIPM, I was fortunate to attend first WIPO Summer School in Nagpur. Definitely, I will help you to how to write statement of purpose and other things so that you will get selected. Then use Google patent search with keywords and learn to comprehend how they have claimed their drafts. Because even during first session, some of you are interested in patent drafting. So patent drafting, no one can teach you. It requires a lot of practice as well as a lot of experience. You need to go through several patents, those who have been granted. Okay? Then start preparing those who would like to make career as a patent agent. There are a lot of opportunities available, like IP analyst, IP associate, okay? Or you can be IP engineer. Because all R&D departments require those who have knowledge of IP. Basic knowledge they want. Later you can enhance. And even you can participate. There are several quiz competitions as well as patent drafting competitions which are happening across India. And then connect with, so everyone is active on LinkedIn nowadays. So these are all top law firms across the, those who are active in IP domain. Anand and Anand, then Khetan and Co, then RK Diwan, then Remfry and Sagar, Lakshmi Kumaran and Sridharan, Krishna and Saurashtri, Kurana and Kurana. There are a lot many. I just have aapko sirf glimpse diya hai. And if you are really interested as a full-time career, then I will suggest you to go for LLB after your graduation. Because that will give you complete idea. Because IP agents have that provision to practice before controller general. He or she can fight your case regarding any IP protection, infringement, or anything else. And if you did your law as well, it will add another privilege. Okay? So these are all next steps you can take in a small or baby steps. So many ideas grow better when transplanted into another mind, that the one whether they sprang up. So it's not like that. हमने बहुत डिस्कस किया कि अगर आपको आइडिया आपके तो फिर डोंट डिस्क्लोज और एनीथिंग एल्स, बट इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट. यू कैन मेक अ टीम, यू कैन स्टार्ट इम्प्लीमेंटिंग, क्योंकि एक बंदा कुछ नहीं कर सकता है. सो यू कैन हैव कोलैबोरेशन, यू कैन कोलैबोरेट विद गुड रिसर्च लैब्स. इन पुणे यू आर फॉर्चुनेट इनफ टू हैव NCL, IITM, DIIT, लॉट मेनी. देर आर सेवरल लैब्स ऑल्सो, लॉट ऑफ फैसिलिटीज आर अवेलेबल एंड यू जस्ट ट्राई टू कोलैबोरेट विद देम. So that's it from my side. I don't have time, that's why even presentation, I have three options available, but according to time, I played this smaller one. We can interact, right, later on as well. So these are my contact details, mail ID and other thing, all of you have. So if you have any doubt or anything else, or if you want anything else, any kind of support in future as well, you just let us know. And those who come from outstation participants and other thing, definitely we would love to help you through AIC and other initiatives. Okay, so let's call quickly because we are running short of time. So who would like to start? Mind Benders or Sush? Out of the blue, anyone? Those who would like to take the lead. Yahan pe kone leader? No one? So let's start with Vita Foodie then.
आपको
चार चार
पहुंच जाओ. हाँ दिक्कत तो नहीं है?
नहीं। क्या ये 4:45? माइक अपना बैकग्राउंड फर्स्ट स्लाइड तक, फर्स्ट स्लाइड मेरे माइक दे दो, माइक दे दो। तीन ही लोग आप, तिघत जण आहे तुम्ही, बोलवा ना सगळ्यांना, बोलवा ना।
Good afternoon, respected teachers, sir and ma'am. On the basis of the topic given for IPR, our team, the team name Vita Foodie, that is vital. Food is important, one of the important aspects of our life. We can't live without food. So that's why Vita Foodie. So in general, I will explain in short, as the sir said. The ideas came. The idea should be there for innovation. So the first step is, firstly, you need to observe what you can invent. It's something innovatory. So first is the observation, first step. Second is the attention. On the basis of observation, what can be newly done? That's the thing. Then hypothesis, on the basis of that. Then product formulation. Then is testing. After that, feedback. Then implementation and launch. With respect to this, I will take an example, which is always inventory. It's a new one. For example, we are planning to have a drug which is anti-carcinogenic, but it is a probiotic. You know that the probiotics are mainly for boosting the immune system, but right now still there is no any probiotic which is also helpful as an anti-carcinogenic agent. So that's why we are trying to develop a drug, D-Drags. D stands for our team, the name is there, and it is similar like that of drugs. So that's D-Drags. So what is the idea? To identify those microorganisms which are having the potential which can act as an anti-carcinogenic by having on their surface the marker antigens. So first is the idea comes in our mind, then make a hypothesis. On the basis of that, the product is designed by isolation of these microorganisms, their characterization and culture. Then after their culture, the testing is required. Means without testing we can't go directly in the market. So the testing is mainly animal testing, and second is what is the nutritional content, clinical testing. If there is no any side effect, no any bad impact is there, so that is given a green signal that yes, I can do this, our team can make that one. Then on the basis of that, the product is formulated. It is the customer's feedback is also taken for the drug, whether they are means mainly the cancer patients, obviously. And on the basis of that, if it is having a good signals, means we have to test it, whether there is increase in the antibody titer with respect to the carcinogenic agent. If it is showing a positive results, obviously it will be the formulated and implemented and launched in the market as the name D-Rags. That's it.
Okay, let's have a big round of applause.
The title, I can say, cancer just beat it.
Great, great.
Thank you all.
Balcony, you are also going to present. Don't discuss among yourself, okay? Next team, Fitbit. And please, don't do conjusi in clapping, right? You need to appreciate. Thank you. You have only 3 minutes with you.
So mic check. Am I audible, guys?
Yes. Start.
बीच में का नाम क्या है कौन है वो
रवान दे सर
इति जोरी
इति इति
सो गाइस कैन आई प्लीज हैव योर अटेंशन गाइस एट द बैक आई एम रिगनिंग माय प्रेजेंटेशन या सो इंडिया इज नोन फॉर ऑथेंटिसिटी ट्रेडिशन एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एंड आवर प्रोडक्ट इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दीज थ्री सो वी गोना गो वी गोना बी द मोस्ट revolutionary product in the fitness market. So what we have is beats from Varanasi and we have technology of the Fitbit band and we're combining these two technologies and giving a revolutionary and amazing product. Now my beloved friend Tejas Prithviraj will explain the uses and the highlights.
Basically our product is for safety purpose. It has a GPS tracking device which can track our position. Basically females in the outskirts can use it, and it also has the ability to track our heartbeats and the steps we take daily, so we can use it as a fitness tracker, and it can also be able to help to stop the kidnapping and all such cases. It can be used for safety purpose in small childs and all. So our product is basically that.
Of fitness with safety, and we are highlighting that Beats because that is the GI. So GI ko uska khud ka value mile, uska originality barkarar rakke, with some innovations we are adding that fitness chip in it, and along with that some at safety level. Yeah. Varanasi Beats, it's already having GI mark on it. It's GI, right? Beats, glass beads. बीड्स हाँ सो उसी बीड्स को लेके वी विल बी प्रिपेयरिंग अ ज्वेलरी एंड इन दैट ज्वेलरी वी विल बी हैविंग एट द सेंटर पोजिशन दैट चिप इज मेंट फॉर द फिटनेस एज वेल एज द सेफ्टी पर्पज एज वेल सो टू इन वन रोल इट विल प्ले प्लस यू आर एनकरेजिंग द ओरिजिनलिटी ऑफ अवर ओन कंट्री राइट
As ma'am mentioned, our jewelry, our fit bead, uses Varanasi glass beads, which has a GI, registered GI. So it not only encourages local craftsmen, and it also gives it that aesthetic look. We've branded it that way, that it gives it that aesthetic look that can not only be sold in India, but also internationally, because again, it's got that Indian feel to it.
We are also having the app application for this. Basically, we are developed the Fitbit app, which has also patent for its programming and coding. And we are also having the patent for the chips, given chips.
That's it. It's more fashionable like Big Bari in Pune, or like the Maharashtrians have it. It's value-based because of its natural heritage. Celebs from UP, like native celebs, will also endorse the same. It comes on a very cheap cost, not like gold jewelry, which will cost you more. It's easily replaceable. Work to local artisans, I need to empower them. It's trendy in fashion. Skill India will be uplifted in true sense. Marketing will be done through websites and apps. Domain name will be registered through INDRP. So all in all, copyright, patent, trademark, registrations with INDRP and domain name. So we have tried to cover as much as we can.
Even the ultimate packaging box will be even
Will be a GI, Bandhani or something.
So we're trying to
maximize all the IPs that we can stuff in. Yeah.
We're giving them more income.
All IPs are being covered.
So
it looks. So it can be used as a necklace. It can be used as an anklet and as a
bracelet.
There are three uses. Also having the box.
I just have one question. What about the existing companies like Titan? Because Titan also has a
watch, very fancy.
Even Xiaomi has it, but then the one who brought it first.
Most of these watches are functional, not fashionable.
Yeah, laptop mein copy kar liya abhi direct.
Fashionable fit.
This is more like an accessory than a utility. Accessory plus utility.
Small press can add fitness.
Yeah. Okay, let's have a big round of applause to Team Fitbit. Thank you. Phonix, quickly. Power Warriors, be ready. Power Warriors, okay, be ready after them. Phoenix, you have 3 minutes with you. You start quickly.
Hello. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Suyash Garg and we are Phoenix. So we are here to present our firm, and the firm name is Pot Poetry. So I like to give a small explanation why we keep this name. So Pot has different. Hello. Pot has different shape, shape, which makes is feel like patterns. I'll say rather patterns, which makes feel it like it has got certain rhythm. So we'll go for name Pot Poetry, and hence our trademark will is same, this Pot. Now our domain name is www.portpoetry.com, and further I would like to hand mic to my
friend. Good afternoon, everyone. So the main aspect of this Pot, I will explain its patents. So it's covering main 3 points. That is, it's new, it's novel. New as in the Pot is completely technologically advanced. It has IoT enabled features. Second, it has a enabled device in it which will tell you when the water level is low and when you need to fill in the water. Second, it has a decorative mesh which is not only decorative but it has function as well. So it inhales toxic air around its surrounding and it gives out clean air. So it's completing the features of new, that it's completely new in the market. Nothing like this is available before. Second, it has inventive steps, that the overall process is made in such a way that all these things are incorporated correctly. Third, it has industrial applicability, means it will be mass produced and it will be available for the masses. Okay, so the GI, geographical indications will be explained by sir.
Good afternoon all. Actually, the soil which required to make the pot is available at Mulamuta River. So it will be very convenient to set up GI as a Loni Kalbur.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm here to present the topic, and I'm going to talk about design process. Basically, it is unique design, and it contains that some devices which tells us about the water level in that product, which tells us about the water level in that pot, and it also contains a net product on upper side which absorbs the CO2 available in the atmosphere around that, and it has some name over there, Phoenix, on the pot type.
As we all know, the available surrounding around us, how much it is polluted. So Phoenix stands for which has the apex value. So it is giving you signals for means planting the plants as well as inhaling the CO2. So it's a one in all package. So we are calling it Phoenix.
So copyright, because already my friend explained a lot about technologies we used here. So we are going to get copyright for source code. And so anyone like to invest in our project can contact us. Yes, sir.
Okay, so the product is launching coming Friday. It is available for 999 rupees, and customers can register their interest at www.potpoetry.com. Okay. ask as in what are you gaining from this?
Please get the terminology right, then you probably come back to the investors.
Okay, sure.
Okay, let's have a big round
of applause. Thank you, everyone.
Power Warriors.
Namko ji.
So basically, I would like to start with one thing that basically the idea of this presentation was to find a product who has got the maximum number of innovations, the IPRs in it. So the thing which is trending right now that comes to your mind is a JCB loader. If you can see, it must have more than 1500 patents in it, patents regarding the mechanical things we can get in it. So basically, they also have the industrial design right for it. The logo has been trademarked. So this is the product which completely sets in the example of that. So what we are going to do is over here is that, as per our name, the Power Warriors, a JCB is a highly powerful machine, isn't it? So when the things come, you must have seen the videos on the YouTube. When the equipment is extra used, the efficiency of the man to handle that perfect machinery is difficult because the views and the perspective the driver get are not enough for him to drive the vehicle carefully, avoiding the accident continuously. So our concept is to design a circuit and design a computer program, that is KCB, that is collective circuit board, which will be working on a computer program. It can be a copyright as a computer program, and also a circuit can be patented, and we will be having a trademark of KBC or KCB. So by this way, we are going to start a company. The program is going to facilitate the work of a technical thing, means it is a sensing element what we are going to put in it. So it can avoid the accident, so it can also come in the process of a patent. We can also patent the program because the end application is a mechanical application. So this is what we have developed a program for, and this is our product.
Sush, Sush kone, Sush, be ready next to them. Chhara pay na kar. Kya ho gaya?
Ja raha hai. Kitne leke aao?
Good afternoon, everyone. Hello. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone. Our product is iLocket. We have heard about iPad and iWatches have also come. So we are introducing iLocket. And then our team name is Out of the Blue, and our logo is I, and what is the tagline?
Guardian.
Your personal guardian. Your personal guardian is our tagline. So now Zef will tell more about the overview of the product.
Okay, so first of all, on behalf of the entire team, a very good afternoon to everyone and all the delegates present. Actually, basically, what task we are given is to create a summary from all the 3 days of workshop that we have had, and to take in ideas from that and create a product which, according to you, will get the right. We don't need patents and rights in the mass numbers, we just need that right one. So the name, first of all, iLocket, it has the iLocket, which we consider I aa gaya to matlab Apple hai. So what we did is, we took the example of China wala thing, the iPad. सो इन फ्यूचर अगर कभी एप्पल जाके कुछ ऐसा बनाता है द अल्टीमेट GPS और एनीथिंग लाइक दैट देन ही हैज टू कम टू अस टू पे अस फॉर आई लोकेट नेम या इट्स बेटर टू ड्रीम दैट मच देन टू ड्रीम नथिंग देन द डिजाइन पार्ट विच वुमेन इन दिस वर्ल्ड डजंट लाइक अ गुड लॉकेट यू नो शी कैन मेक यू रोम अराउंड फ्रॉम रोम टिल इटली बट गिव यू अ गुड लॉकेट to have help a good locket. So there we have a good great locket which all the specifications will be told to you and it has all the things which we have tried to insert in a small because we can say that you have a locket over here, how can you insert everything in it? You have an Apple Watch, how is everything in that? So we have created all the softwares and everything so that it could be fitted into that and one by one all the team members present over here will tell you how our product has that right patent which is important to create a product and you might say ki it is not available for the masses there's a quote by the owner of Louis Vuitton he has said that the maximum margin that you can get is from expensive products so yes our product is not for the masses but our money is in the masses
to start with one of the specification as you can see here there's a blood pressure and a diabetes detector So there'll be a needle over here. It will be replaceable and for hygiene purposes, you can every time pick up the needle and check your blood with blood pressure. Blood for blood pressure, you will have a locket over here. So you have to set a mode over there. The button over here on the eye. There'll be a change the mode and you can have the blood pressure checked by just placing the locket near your heart. And this will indicate your diabetics by pinching the finger with the blood.
Hi everyone. Talking about functionality is basically it is derived from the smartwatch. So it will feature a AMOLED screen and all. It will even have GPS and it will have an SOS button which will if we press that one it will change modes cause workout. Normal your city and then if you press it 3 times it is gonna send your location to anyone you set on it so basically it has a Python operating system which reduced all the software loads in a minimal amount of space
I want to explain its utility. Mostly women wears locket. So for the women, it can be wear around the neck. And for the men, it is the armband. It can wear around the arm. And this chain is adjustable. Means you can stretch it or fit it. And again, explained by the Samiksha.
There are things like chain snatching and all is going on around. So we have a special feature around here. This is a fingerprint lock. So the chain only opens and closes with your specific fingerprint so that the person using it has the access to it.
Yeah, and the list of patents, ma'am will quickly tell us.
Yes, we'll be registering trademark on name and then logo. And the design registration will do on the pendant, hinges, lock, and there'll be several softwares will be patented. Like there is one for diabetes check, heartbeat check, then BP check, then 6-axis gyro sensor.
Yes.
For that also. Then we'll register copyright for color, unique, like normally gems are available in certain colors, but we'll mix and match certain colors. So it will become a premium product, which will be different than the normal gems, like topaz and ruby and all. So this product will be different.
Okay.
Then the software for efficient batteries, software for automatic charging, interchangeable, like from locket to this thing band then fingerprint opening and alarm and all SOS alarm and that's it so we are actually found out nearly 19 patents IPs
99
on this product.
Okay, let's have a big round of applause for Out of the Blue for iLocket. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
This is only for on the idea that we have to create something from here. So the gems idea was taken from the cake picture, different colors, and then the case between China and I, we took eye from that, nothing else. Other than that, there was no idea.
Okay, just before getting into next presentation, on behalf of MIT EDT University, we would like to felicitate Divya ma'am for her constant support, and I would like to request Dr. Mohit Dubey to do the honor. Let's have a big round of applause for her. Let's have a big round of applause, man. Thank you, ma'am.
It's an honor to receive this from you. Because
she has to catch the flight, okay. I will ask her for 1 minute if you would like to share feedback. Yes.
Okay. First of all, just give yourselves a pat on the back and maybe 3 cheers. Okay, hip hip. My past 3 to 4 years of experience, this has by far been the best crowd, and this is the first time I'm speaking. Thank you so much for being such a lovely audience. And in conclusion, I would just like to say that I'm a very filmy person and I love Bollywood. So you can all be the makeup Sids, but do try to be the first of Bangaru in your life. It's a lovely weather outside, and you've been here from the morning till the evening without fail. Thank you so much. You guys are more sincere than I ever was as a student. Thank you. Thank you so much.
All right, so let's have group number 7, Sush team. Let's give them a huge round of applause. Now they are here to present their topic.
And then next team would be
you can start.
Good afternoon, everyone. Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
All right. So, it is a very sad thing to say that more than 1 lakh road accidents, that to two-wheelers, happen in our country, which leads to ultimate death. So, it is not just that people are not having protection against it, but also that people are not following rules because they are boring and quite uncomfortable. Am I right? So now everyone is quite attentive. Am I right? Okay. So let me just introduce you my product, which is called Swoosh. Now I can see a few of you guys are judging us because this is a picture of a drawn helmet. But it is not a simple helmet. It has got some quite premium features and very comfortable features. First of all, let me just say this to you. It has got GPS tracking. You would never ever lose your helmet. You would never have to invest one more time in your helmet. Secondly, whenever this helmet gets hit, it has a system in which an in-helmet airbag or whatever you can say, a sack bag or whatever, it protects your head so that ultimately it would save your life. And the third thing, it is as light as air. It is literally as light as air. So it is ultimately very, very comfortable for you to wear this. And the fourth thing, which is quite unique and also quite inventory, I would say, is that when you ride wearing these helmets on, you would have four dots of red LEDs at your back. So even in very dark, you know, dark environments, vehicles from your back could easily recognize you. Isn't it exciting? Okay, some are discussing within their own. All right. So now, where did I cover all the IPs in it? First of all, the material design protection. We would be having material design protection within the material for with the material by which we would be creating our helmets. So as I said, our helmets would be super light. And when I say it's super light, it's literally super light. Secondly, we would be having a patent over our design of LED lights at our back. All right, and the third thing, we would be having a patent on the in-helmet air sacs or airbags or whatever. Now I would like to hand over this mic to my friend who would be explaining the commercialization of this product.
All right. We will buy a domain name under the name digitalpagadi.com. We find it very catchy, and since we are from Pune and we know the geographical indications of Pune, so we find digitalpagadi.com will help people get these helmets over there. And we do have our intercalling system. The system will help you whenever, if you hit some road, if you hit some lamp, then it will have a system to call anyone, apart from your phone calls, and it will help you get the emergency practices soon to you, so that you won't be in like a very big emergency or something like that. And moreover, we'll have a website for selling these items, and apart from that, we'll have manual selling as well. And thank you guys.
All right.
And please
thank
wear
you.
Helmets.
Thank you so much.
Adding to which, I would like to say our slogan would be, "Safe heads, stay ahead." So can we get a huge round of applause for saving lives? Yes, we can. And thank you so much.
Very good. Mind benders now. Team leader, please deposit your presentation because it's MITDT University's property. Okay. Right, so let's begin.
Good afternoon, everyone present here, dignitaries and all respected faculties and students. Our team name is Mind Benders, and the product which we have thought of that is considering as the IP is Tex. It is basically a mobile device. And what the features we are trying to put here is something, as we have heard, we are using mobile, and we know that every day there is a new mobile available in the market with the different features. So considering those,
attributes, what we have thought is designing of something with respect to batteries, with respect to camera phones, and apart from that, operating system. As we are aware that we are using Android. Apart from Android, iOS is there, which is used for iPhones. But what about the other operating systems which are available? How can we feature those operating systems in a mobile device applications? So with respect to that, we'll be discussing what are the different IPs which will be considered or which can be formed with respect to this device. So I will hand over this mic to Ishan so that he will tell more about what are the additional features which you are going to add on to this mobile device.
Ever since the man took his first step from the cage, he has always tried to make his life more comfortable, better, and safe. And we can also see it in the initial industrialization period and the first Macintosh computer invented and launched by Apple, and even the iPhone in 2004 that was also launched by Steve Jobs by Apple. We can see that he has also tried to take a step further and improve the quality of life by making the computers portable. So we Mindbenders are taking a step ahead by introducing text. And I'd like to hand over the mic to Samir.
Hello friends. You would have heard about in-screen fingerprint sensors. Now they have been widely used nowadays, but they are optical sensors. Now what we are trying to do is bring an ultrasonic sensor in the screen. Now the problem with optical sensors is that they shoot a beam of light. So if you are at night, then you will get a max brightness light in front of your face. So that's quite uncomfortable. Now ultrasound, we can't hear and we also can't see. So it won't have any issues. So basically, we'll put an ultrasound sensor near the bottom of the screen. So when you press your finger, the ultrasonic rays will touch your hand, will clash against your finger, and they will analyze the data and basically give a better result than the optical sensors. Okay. And I would like to hand the mic to Rohan.
Thank you, Samir. As the name suggests, TechX. X will demonstrate the revolutionary thing that we are trying to supply. So here we are using fuel cells instead of the traditional lithium-ion battery. Even though they make a huge cost difference, they will actually play big in the long run for systems. As we have shown here, the fuel cells will be designed in a smaller manner, which will be placed behind the battery, and they will take in hydrogen from the source that is already present inside, and the headphone jack, which is already present in the phones, will sweep out the water vapor produced in the battery, and this can make the phone last for like a week with zero problems, and yeah, this is the intelligent energy. Thank you.
Right. Thank you. Thank you very much.
We have with us Dr. Mohit Dubey, sir, an alumnus of Australia-India Youth Dialogue. Sir has an overall global experience of more than 19 years. He is currently the CEO of Atal Incubation Center at MIT ADT University. He was the Pro Vice Chancellor at IFTM University, Moradabad, before his current position. His IT experience spanned over a decade with India's second largest IT company, Infosys. He moved up the value chain, starting as a software engineer to client solutions manager in pre-sales function in a very short span of time. His main interest areas include banking and capital markets, in which he completed the certification in capital derivative market from National Stock Exchange in India. I would like to invite Sir to address the gathering on the topic of Atal Innovation Mission.
Thank you.
So let me first do a quick time check. This is 3:52. How much time do we have? 20 minutes, okay. So this is so funny about startup world, right? So originally you were allotted 1 hour, and now what you get is actually 20 minutes. Bless you. And you're supposed to wrap up your talk in 20 minutes and still expected to make some sense out of it. Okay, so thank you, Suraj, for inviting me and having me over here for discussing about what Atal Innovation Mission is all about and the startup opportunities that exist on this campus. Let me just do a quick check. How many of you are from MIT ADD campus? Most of them. There are few. Can I just have a quick raise of hand? How many of you are outside of MIT ADD? Fantastic. I didn't intend to get this in a MIT ADD heavy kind of a forum, but then in the interest of time, how many of you can relate to what that video was? I mean, I intended to do a different talk, and now that we have a curtailed time, I want to, you know, completely change it from what we saw in the video. Kitne logo lagta hai ki startup ki duniya itni aasan hai? Log, idea hai mere paas, presentation kiya, logo ke paas jaiye, paisa milega, party kijiye, ghar chale jaiye. Or base dijiye company. Itna aasan hai kya startup? How many of you think that startup mein fundraising, jaisa dikhaya tha ki party karne ke liye paisa milta hai? Kitne logo ko milta hai? कितने लोगों ने पेटीएम का नाम सुना है? सभी लोगों ने सुना है. पेटीएम कितना पैसा बनाता है पर क्वार्टर? गेसेस प्लीज, फटाफट, लेट्स डू इट क्विकली. नहीं, आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट द नेटवर्थ, वी विल कम टू दैट नेटवर्थ पार्ट. आई एम सेइंग कितना पैसा बनाता है हर क्वार्टर में, अगर बोले. हाँ, एनी गेसेस? 20 मिलियन बनाता है. Please understand, Paytm loses 4,000 crore every quarter. Every quarter, Paytm loses 4,000 crore. How much? Why do you think Flipkart was sold out to Walmart at $16 billion? I'm just giving you the live examples. Why do you think they were sold out? Because they were not able to raise money for their money. No fool in the planet was interested to make them survive, because the only model that had was the discounting model. Do you think Flipkart has ever made a money? Has ever made a money other than the founders of Flipkart? Has Flipkart as a company has made ever money? No. Kitne logon ne Taxi for Sure ka naam suna hai? Kisko becha tha unhone? Kitne mein becha tha? 1200 crore. They are my college juniors. क्यों बेचा था? सर्वाइवल वॉज डिफिकल्ट. सर्वाइवल वॉज डिफिकल्ट. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, देर इज नो फ्री मनी. देर इज नो फ्री मनी इन द मार्केट. एंड दैट्स वाई वेन दैट ग्रुप वॉज हियर, वेन दे सेड आई वॉन्ट मनी, राइट? इफ समबडी इज इंटरेस्टेड इन द मनी एंड आई आस्क द क्वेश्चन, व्हाट्स योर आस्क? ये मत सोचिए कि पैसा है मार्केट में इसलिए वो आपके लिए है पैसा. आज का मतलब होता है, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड द टीम विच वॉज देयर. आप मांगना जानिए पहले कि कितना पैसा चाहिए आपको. दैट इज द आस्क. आप किस लिए पैसा चाहते हैं? क्या करेंगे पैसा लेके? पैसा उठाना कितना जरूरी है? पैसा उठाना भी चाहिए या नहीं उठाना चाहिए? द मोस्ट प्रोलिफिक कॉफी चेन इन दिस कंट्री, व्हाट इज दैट? व्हाट हैपेंड टू द फाउंडर ऑफ इट? Why do you think he committed a suicide? Don't you think he could have paid off? He had enough assets to immediately write down all the debts that he had. Please understand, the free money is going to kill you. Those of you who think paisa uthana is the success of a startup, please understand, the success of a startup is only one barometer. क्या है वो barometer? Sorry? वो तो business का है. Startup का क्या है? कोई startup आपके ध्यान में आता हो हिंदुस्तान से जिसने आज तक till date profit बनाया हो? फिर और क्या है स्टार्टअप का बैरोमीटर? प्लीज प्लीज गिव अ राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज टू दैट जेंटलमैन हु सेड सर्वाइवर्स. इट्स बाइनरी, ईदर यू लिव और यू डाई, दैट्स इट. देयर इज नो ग्रे एरिया. आप जब तक जिंदा हैं वो तभी तक आपका स्टार्टअप है. कल अगर आपको मौत आ रही है तो वो स्टार्टअप उतना ही था, बस दैट्स इट. जो सीरियल एंटरप्रेन्योर, सीरियल स्टार्टअप्स, ये जितना सुनते हैं आप लोग, जितना ये मीडिया सावी वर्ल्ड है, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, दे स्विच्ड ओवर टू अ न्यू स्टार्टअप बिकॉज दे कुड रेज न्यू मनी बिकॉज दे कुड नॉट सर्वाइव ऑन द फर्स्ट वन. व्हेन यू सेल समवन, व्हेन यू सेल योर स्टार्टअप समवन, व्हाई डू यू, बाय द वे, व्हाई डू यू स्टार्ट अ वेंचर, एनी वेंचर? यू नो लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु आर देयर, especially the ones who are trying to make a social impact, right? The ones in the jinhone bola ki wo loni ke gi ko use karna chahte hain, banaras ko karna chahte hain, helmet ko karna chahte hain, why do you think you are going to start that venture? Because that's your paisa to hai, sabko paisa kamana hai, aisa thodi na bina kisi paise ke kaam karna, dharmarth to karna nahi, charity karni nahi hai, kyu karna chahiye? That's your passion, right? That's, you think that's your passion. If it is your passion, do you want to create a business out of a passion to sell it? Or do you want to create a venture out of it so that you can start earning money out of it? Please understand there's a difference between a value and a valuation. What is value? What is the value? How do you define value? Somebody actually mentioned it here, right here on this stage. Somebody mentioned what is value. Agar main aapke jeevan mein कुछ पॉजिटिव प्रभाव छोड़ पाऊं, कुछ भी मैं कर रहा हूं, सिंपल प्रोसेस चेंज किया मैंने जीवन में, सिंपल प्रोडक्ट लेके आया, कुछ सर्विस किया, इफ आई कैन मेक अ चेंज इन योर लाइफ विच यू वुड गिव अ रिस्पेक्ट टू मी फॉर दैट, इज इन दैट द वैल्यू? व्हाट इज वैल्यूएशन? Which is the highest valued company these days? Okay, some people were mentioning about that. Is Apple a most highly valued company, or is that the most the market capitalization is the highest for that company? Okay, so what is the difference between the market cap and the valuation? Market cap is determined by your stock price and the number of shares, right? That's the market cap. That's why it's called market capitalization. It's a listed entity. It's a listed entity. That's why you talk about market capitalization. What is value? Which is the most valued company in the country or in the world? No, it's a listed company. It's a listed entity. Amazon is a listed entity. Startup valuation. To startup ki baat kar rahe na? Kaun sa hai? हाँ, सॉरी, रामको इज अ कंपनी. रामको में वो 20% अभी खरीदा ना रिलायंस को. हाँ, तो दैट्स अ बिग कंपनी. सॉरी, टिकटॉक किसने सुना है? कितना वैल्यूएशन है उस कंपनी का? $75 billion. गो एंड कैलकुलेट दैट, हाउ मेनी जीरोज इट वुड हैव इन रुपी टर्म्स. $1 billion बाय द वे इज 7,000 crore. Multiplied that with 75 and then start counting the zeros in that. What do you think what that company is all about? What is that company? Do you think that is there a sense in that company? Is there a sense in that company? People thought there is a sense in the company. The investors thought there is a sense in the company. And that's why it's highly valued. If you start accepting money from people as an investor, you start losing the control on the company. And that's why you start losing the soul of the company. How many of you have heard about Mindtree? Mindtree company. Do you think that is not one of the phenomenal examples of this country, how a new company should be built up? By the way, I'm from Infosys. I worked in Infosys for over a decade, but that was 1980. But I'm talking about 2000s. Mindtree is a phenomenal example how few good people can come together and still make a phenomenal brand out of it, right? what happened, and it's related to VGS, Vijay Siddhartha, the founder of Coffee Ray, right? He was forced to sell his share from Mindtree. And Mindtree was acquired by L&T. Is that the normal bidding that you go and ask the company to acquire? No, that's the hostile bidding that they did, right? The entire founder community of that company was against that bidding. But still, money ruled. And people had to forego their lives. So please understand, startup is not the video that was shown to you. Startup is about life and death. It's only about life and death. So if you are really serious about startup, please understand, this is not for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 years. This is not your job that you can start switching from here and there. It's a very, very serious business. It's a very, very serious game. And the fun is, you may never see the fruits of what you are trying to do. Because none of the organizations, be it Apple, be it Microsoft, or anyone, do you wish to be thrown out of your own company? What happened to Steve Jobs? He was thrown out of his own company, right? But then the stars happened, right? Toy Story made good name, and the Pixar studio, he was heading that studio, and then they got reacquired by Apple, right? And then he became the head, and then he churned out some of those phenomenal products that we call those iPhones and iPads and iPods and all those things, right? So please understand that this is all about life and death. Why do you think there is so much focus on startups these days? I'm pretty sure, as Suraj was mentioning, that for the last 3 days you have been pumped up, bulldozed with all the startups and IPRs and whatnot. Why do you think it's so in thing today? Is it fashionable? Is it fashionable? Because as I said, it's life and death, right? So is it fashionable? Bachcha sir, aram se naukri karo ya zindagi kat jayegi. Kyun startup mein jana hai? Jab samne maut hai to. Why do you think it is required now these days? Is everywhere our prime minister goes, he only talks about one thing, which is startup. Why do you think he is so hard pressed? Why do you think he is so hard pressed about it? Can we have the next slide, please? Go ahead, I'll skip this one. I'll come back to this. How many of you understand what is GDP? No, what is GDP? Oh, gross domestic product, to uska full form ho gaya. What is GDP? Sorry? Okay, bukhar agar napa jata hai, to kya kaha jata hai ki saab iska temperature kitna hai? 100 degree hai. यानी कि एक टर्म की बात की जाती है, राइट? तो अगर किसी भी इकोनॉमी को अगर मेजर किया जाए तो उसको जीडीपी के टर्म्स में नापा जाता है, सिंपल से एक में बताया जाए, राइट? देयर आर लॉट ऑफ इंटीग्रिटीज इनटू बिहाइंड दिस, अंडर दिस, आई डोंट वांट टू गेट इनटू दैट, बट देन जीडीपी इज अ बैरोमीटर टू चेक द हेल्थ ऑफ एन इकॉनमी, हेल्थ ऑफ एन इकॉनमी. कैन समबडी हेल्प मी रीडिंग आउट व्हाट इज द साइज ऑफ इंडियन इकॉनमी? 2.6 trillion dollars, right? What is China's economy? अगर तीन भी मान लिया जाए अपना सारे statistics को उड़ा करके और उनका 12 भी कर लिया जाए तो भी कितना है? चार गुना बड़ी साइज है. US से तो बात ही नहीं करेंगे अभी, US से बात नहीं करनी अभी, करेक्ट? वो मोदी जी परसों जा रहे हैं, वहां बात करेंगे वो. सो डू यू थिंक वी एज एन इंडियंस आर only quarter of Chinese people? इतना ही विद्वता है क्या हमारी? अगर इतनी विद्वता कम होती तो चाइना वाले सारे पैसा नहीं लगाते यहाँ पे, राइट? जितनों की हम बात कर रहे हैं कि 4,000 crore का जो लॉस पेटीएम ले रहा है वो किसके पैसा है? सो अली बाबा इज द कंपनी, बट उसके पीछे किसका पैसा है? वो सॉफ्ट बैंक, राइट? अली बाबा इज जैकमा, विच इज द अमेजोन equivalent, right? Amazon is Alibaba there. But the paisa wala portion is SoftBank. Who's the owner and founder of SoftBank? Masayoshi Son. Okay. Achha, by the way, let me ask this question. How many of you know who's the founder of Facebook? Fantastic. Who funded Mark Zuckerberg? Peter Thiel, very few, see? This is what happens, right? If you are doing in masses and everybody thinks we know everything, there are only few who will come out and say, only I know. And that's the reason why, you know what is the failure rate in startup world? Guess. More than 90%. Around that, 94-95%. तो ऐसा तो हो नहीं सकता कि सब लोग इसकी बात भी कर रहे हैं और सारे फेल भी हो रहे हैं. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड दिस. इफ यू रीड द हिस्ट्री ऑफ आवर एजुकेशन सिस्टम, व्हेन वाज द फर्स्ट यूनिवर्सिटी एस्टैब्लिश इन दिस कंट्री? नो नो, द मॉडर्न वर्ल्ड ऑफ एजुकेशन सिस्टम, 1857. ओके, द फर्स्ट सेट ऑफ यूनिवर्सिटी सिस्टम दैट वॉज क्रिएटेड, you know, the 1905 BHU started, AMU started, some of the other universities started, Central University started, right? What was the core concept why those university systems were created, universities were created? To build the character of the citizen of this country. Because at that time, Gandhi ji ka daur tha, azadi chahiye thi, ye sare factors chahiye the. So we wanted to build the character of the citizens of this country. Taki wo social science samjhe, networking samjhe. जैसे आजादी हुई उसके बाद कौन से संस्थान शुरू हुए? When was the first IIT established? 1951. IIT खड़गपुर. ओके, IIT खड़गपुर 1951. यानी कि अभी 3-4 साल ही हुए थे अपनी आजादी को, 47 से 3-4 साल. पंडित जी रियलाइज दैट दिस इज नॉट द वे इंडिया वुड सक्सीड, बिकॉज इफ यू हैव टू डिपेंड अपॉन टेक्नोलॉजी साइंस ऑन द फॉरनर्स, दिस कंट्री इज नॉट गोइंग टू ग्रो. That's why he started the concept of IITs. And then 58 to 62 ke beech mein baki IITs aane shuru hue, 4 IIT, fir NIT ka culture shuru hua. Aaj desh mein kitne IITs hain? 23 IITs hain. Kitne NITs hain? 31 NITs hain. Aur bahut sare CSR labs hain wagera, jitne bhi Suraj ji ne bataya, baki sare ye sab sansthan kyon create kiye gaye the? Because we wanted to produce the graduates who could change the fate of India, right? Who could go out and stamp the authority that, boss, we come from India. And we all are part of that system. We went to Harvard, we went to Oxford, we went to Australia. We could stamp our authority and say that I come from Infosys, right? And people knew that what India is. Before that, bahar mein kya chalta tha? क्या समझते थे लोग इंडिया को? द लैंड ऑफ स्नेक चार्मर्स. वो तो बहुत पहले गोल्डन बर्ड, तो गोल्ड रश में निकल गया सब. हाँ, द लैंड ऑफ स्नेक चार्मर्स. आई टेल यू, देयर वाज अ पिक्चर ऑफ इन 2004 दैट अपीयर्ड इन द, यू नो, इन द फ्रंट पेज इन वन ऑफ द यूएस डेलीज, वेयर द ईवीएम्स वर बीइंग कैरीड on elephant, right? And the picture showed there were rugged roads and टूटा हुआ रास्ता था और हाथी उस EVM मशीन को लेकर के जा रहा है. So I was at Bank of America and the client asked me, Mohit, this is the fate of India. You don't have roads and you are thinking about EVMs. I said, well, this is the largest democracy in the world. We may not have roads, but we have the best technology to cast the votes. Meaning thereby, our approach towards facing the world was changed by these institutions, by the companies that were created in that era, which is TCS, Infosys, Wipro, and all those things, right? And now why do you see Bangalore is the hotbed of startups? Why do you think that happened? Why do you think Pune could not latch on to that kind of a growth? What is the contribution of Pune in the overall startup scene in the country? Any guesses? Can everybody read that? 2%. Why do you think it happened? Bangalore is 25%. Why do you think that 25% is there? Because the first generation of companies, were based out of Bangalore. Do you think, can you remember any of these top startups that India has produced who doesn't have a baniya name, surname? Baniya surname, Agarwal, Gupta, Bell, anybody who is the owner of one of these unicorns, for example, and doesn't have a baniya surname? Which is? The startup.
He sold his website, Google Adsense.
But do you think people remember that as in the Agarwals and the Bansals of the world? Not really, right? So what I'm trying to tell you is that there was this whole plethora of knowledge support that existed in Bangalore because of that generation, which was handheld and passed on to this new set of aggressive baniya community people who went across to the places, and they said that if you can pass on the information, if you can give me access to the world, because you have seen the world, right? You know what is dollar. If you know what is dollar, I want to earn dollar. You know what I'm saying? And that did not happen elsewhere. Pune has a phenomenal manufacturing history. Tata, Bajaj, Kirloskars, everyone is here. They are even older than these guys, right? But the only factor that happened was these new startups were mentored by these old generation people. Now, can you see the difference between a mentoring and a teaching? I come back to the whole question of the education system, right? When we all are sitting in an education system, what is the role of our teachers? Versus, are they teachers or are they mentors also? Please. What is the difference between a mentor and a teacher?
Sir, teacher is like a spoon feeding and mentor is like asking to have food. Teacher teaches a subject or mentor guides.
So there are these set of rules, right? If you go to a college, there are these subjects, there are these teachers who have been tagged with those subjects. They're supposed to complete that subject. You know, sessionals after sessionals, class after class, 40 hours ka subject hoga, beech mein ek midterm hoga, CT hoga. This is a set routine of a college, right? And it has to be delivered, thankfully, it has to be delivered in a one to many relationship, which is typically from an AICT standpoint of view, 1:2, kitne ka batch hai sir, ek apne yahan par, AICT 60 का बोलता है, तो यानी कि 1:60, फिर वो आपको पता नहीं शायद, जब ये आईटी वर्ल्ड आया तो लोगों ने सीएस में तीन ही बैच मिलते थे, तो 180 हो गया पूरा सबके पास, सब कॉलेज ने आईटी ब्रांच और ले ली, और आज तक उन सभी लोगों से पूछता हूँ कि सीएस और आईटी में डिफरेंस क्या है, तो साहब वही सिलेबस है, वही पढ़ा रहे हैं, वही बुक्स है, राइट? सब जगह आईटी ज़्यादातर बंद हो गई है, राइट? सब जगह वो सीएस में या तो मर्ज कर दी गई है या सीएस बचा हुआ है. So the point is that teachers are supposed to teach you what they know, number one. What has been asked to deliver, because books hai unke paas mein. Unko syllabus diya hai, course structure diya hua hai. Unko evaluation karna hai har ek bachche ka. Results nikalna hai. Ye sab unka job hai. That is what teachers are supposed to do. Has any teacher spoken to you like a question that I asked, what's your ask? Will you expect any teacher to ask you, भैया business plan लिखते हो क्या? ये जो तुम्हारा idea है, ये जो तुम जिस पे भी काम करना चाहते हो project पे, I am not interested in that project. What I am interested in is it, इसको 10 लाख लोग कैसे subscribe करेंगे? इस देश में कितने लोग हैं? 130 करोड़. Can we even afford to look at the ideas that would only impact lakhs? Unit has to be crores, at least 1 crore, at least 1 crore. कुछ अगर काम करना चाहते हैं तो ये सोच के चलिए कि जब तक 1 करोड़ आदमी तक मेरी कैसे पहुंच होगी, जब तक वो माइंड नहीं आएगा तब तक आप प्रोजेक्ट्स करेंगे। और प्रोजेक्ट्स किस लिए किए जाते हैं? ताकि मार्क्स अच्छे मिले, गोल्ड मेडल अच्छा मिले, सिल्वर मेडल अच्छा मिले कॉन्वोकेशन में, बिकॉज दैट्स द रोल ऑफ अ एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूशन। एंड नाउ व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द व्हाट इज द टारगेट फॉर इंडियन इकॉनमी, $5 trillion इन 2024, दैट मीन्स 5 years फ्रॉम नाउ। पूरी दुनिया ने ताकत लगा ली इस हिंदुस्तान के आज़ादी के बाद से, अब तक 70 साल हो गए, कितने की इकॉनमी बना पाए वो लोग, कितने की इकॉनमी बनी है? 2.67 trillion. अब हम लोग कह रहे हैं 5 साल में इसको डबल करना है। ऐसा कौन सा देवी देवता आएगा जो पैसा टपकाना शुरू करेगा कि $1 trillion इकॉनमी बन जाएगी? क्या उसी तरीके से चलेंगे तो वहां पहुंचेंगे जहां पहुंचना है? अगर वही करते रहोगे जो करते आए हो तो मिलेगा वही जो मिलता आया है। अगर कुछ और पाना है तो नजरिया बदलना पड़ेगा, है ना? और नजरिया कैसे बदला जाएगा? इसे पढ़ लिख करके, टीचिंग, जैसा मैंने बताया कि जब सिस्टम स्टार्ट हुआ था एजुकेशन का, द बेस्ट टीचर वॉज हु हैड द एक्सेस टू इंफॉर्मेशन, हु हैड एन एक्सेस टू इंफॉर्मेशन, बिकॉज द टीचर यूज टू गो एंड स्टडी फॉर 2 books, ही वुड कंसॉलिडेट, ही वुड मेक नोट्स, एंड देन ही वुड डिलीवर लेक्चर टुमारो, फॉर एग्जाम्पल। डू यू थिंक दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम एनी मोर? I am dead sure that you will have more access to information than I have. So the teaching has gone. There's no teaching left if it was only focused on transforming the or transferring the information. And that's why this whole concept of mentoring has started coming in. See, if go ahead and do what you want. I'm not bothered about it. Right? But if you are stuck somewhere, come back to me and let's discuss it out. Let's try to create solution which is going to be your solution, not my solution. I'm only hand-holding you. Because my success is in your success. I can't feel my success in 70 odd people in the class or 180 ka batch pe. And that's why it will never happen. You'll only create unemployable resources in the economy. And that's why all these reports that you see, it only talks about unemployable resources. But kahan se aa rahe, kyun aa rahe hain wo sab? Kitne log graduate hote hain har saal is desh mein? 1.5 crore. Kitne logon ko job naukri de payega ye economy? Option kya hai? Jab tak har choti choti jagah pe aise aise ventures nahi banenge जो कम से कम 10 लोग 20 लोग को सपोर्ट नहीं करेंगे, डू यू थिंक पुणे इज लिवेबल सिटी एनी मोर? डू यू थिंक बैंगलोर इज लिवेबल सिटी एनी मोर? बैंगलोर का एयरपोर्ट से शहर आने में 3 घंटा लगता है। सो इफ एवरीबडी थिंक्स कि दैट लेट्स गो बैक टू बैंगलोर, पुणे, हैदराबाद, डू यू थिंक इंडिया विल प्रोग्रेस टू $5 trillion इकॉनमी? वी नीड टू टॉक अबाउट द GIs. Because there is an inherent strength in those GIs, right? Kitne district hai is desh mein? 725. Kitne gaon hai is desh mein? 7 lakh. Wahan jab tak create nahi hoga, jab tak wahan par change nahi hoga, Pune mein samasya jaisi hai, bagal se nadi bahegi, pani lekin टैंकर से ही आएगा, पानी टैंकर से ही आएगा। खूब बारिश हुई है और आज ही अखबार में है कि देयर इज गोइंग टू बी अ वाटर कट, राइट? सी इफ यू रीड समवॉट महात्मा गांधी, ही सेड वन थिंग, द मदर नेचर हैज गिवन इनफ टू सेटिस्फाई द नीड्स ऑफ अ ह्यूमन बींग, बट मदर नेचर हैज नॉट गिवन इनफ टू सेटिस्फाई द ग्रीड्स ऑफ अ ह्यूमन बींग। सो द चैलेंज इज that everybody has become greedy in a sense that chalo Delhi chalte hain, Bangalore chalte hain, Pune chalte hain, wahin pe kuch hoga. Aur usse kya ho raha hai wo sabko pata hai. उससे क्या हो रहा है वो सबको पता है. सो आई थिंक एज आई सेड द इट्स नॉट एन ऑप्शन एनीमोर टू दिस कंट्री. डू यू वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट डेल्टाज और डू यू वॉन्ट टू रिवोल्यूशनाइज थिंग्स. सब लोग बात करते रहिए इनोवेशन क्या होता है, स्टार्टअप क्या होता है. देयर इज अ एट्थ ग्रेडर हु कम्स टू मी, आई एम टीचिंग हिम पाइथन. एंड देयर इज अनदर 11th ग्रेडर सिटिंग हियर हु इज अ स्कूल ड्रॉप आउट. ही हैज ऑलरेडी बिल्ट द डिजाइनर डॉट AI, 3 AI बेस्ड मॉडल्स एंड अ वीडियो गेम विच इज ऑलरेडी आउट देयर. सो देयर आर द वर्ल्ड इज मूविंग एट अ वेरी वेरी फास्ट पेस एंड दीज आर जस्ट यू नो फ्लैशेज इन द पैन. एम आई हैप्पी विद दैट? नो, आई एम नॉट हैप्पी विद दैम. बिकॉज वी नीड हंड्रेड्स ऑफ देम लाइक दैट. तभी तो चार गुना की जो इकॉनमी का गैप है हमारा चाइना का वो बहुत ज़्यादा है, राइट? सो आई थिंक वी नीड टू पुल अप आवर सॉक्स, थिंक थ्रू इट. वॉट इज इट दैट वी नीड टू डू? वी नीड टू ओनली क्रिएट वन थिंग विच कैन बी इम्पैक्टफुल टू द सोसाइटी, विच कैन क्रिएट लॉट ऑफ इम्पैक्ट टू द सोसाइटी. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, हूएवर वॉज थिंकिंग दैट मनी इज अवेलेबल, जस्ट लाइक द वीडियो सेड, कि पार्टी करने के लिए द मनी इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट. बिकॉज प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड द वे मनी फ्लोज इन द वीसी इंडस्ट्री और प्राइवेट इक्विटी स्पेस, उनका पैसा नहीं होता है, वो भी किसी का पैसा होता है जिनको LPs कहा जाता है, लिमिटेड पार्टनर्स कहा जाता है. उनका कोई भी फंड 7 साल से ज़्यादा ऑपरेट नहीं कर सकता है, उसको बंद करके दूसरा ही फंड खोलना पड़ेगा. तो जितने भी ये फंड हाउसेज आपको दिखते हैं कि इसने इतना पैसा रेस कर लिया, उतना पैसा रेस कर लिया, वो उनकी मजबूरी है उतना पैसा लगाना. वो नहीं लगाएंगे तो बंद हो जाएगा फंड एनी वेज ही, राइट? बट एट द सेम टाइम ऑल द PE प्लेयर्स, ऑल द VC प्लेयर्स वर्क ऑन वन प्रिंसिपल. वॉट इज दैट वन प्रिंसिपल? फोमो इफेक्ट का नाम सुना है क्या? वॉट इज फोमो इफेक्ट? हाँ बताइए, क्या फर्क पड़ता है, सही होगा या गलत होगा, एक ही तो होगा ना. वॉट इज फोमो? फियर ऑफ मिसिंग आउट. वॉट इज दैट मीन? वॉट डज दैट मीन साहब? अगर इन्होंने पैसा लगा दिया और कल इनका पैसा बन गया तो ऐसा लगेगा मेरा LP मुझसे कहेगा तुम बेवकूफ थे, कौन सा हार्वर्ड से डिग्री लेके आए हो? क्योंकि जितने भी एनालिस्ट हैं, जितने भी स्टॉक मार्केट के प्लेयर्स हैं, उन सबको एक ही चीज दिखती है, अगर इसका 1 रुपया 5 रुपया बनता है तो मेरा 1 रुपया 6 रुपया कैसे बनेगा? एंड दैट इज द ओनली ड्राइव दैट दे हैव. दे आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन योर बिजनेस. आप उनको 1 रुपये का 10 रुपये आप गोबर बेच के कमवा दीजिए, दे विल फंड यू. 1 रुपये का 2 रुपया आप उनको सेंसर, आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, चंद्रयान पे जाकर के 3D प्रिंटर अपने आप जो चीजों को बना दे वो बना के दीजिए. किसी को समझ में आता है क्या ये सब? इन्वेस्टर कम्युनिटी ये सब कुछ नहीं समझती है, उनको इससे कोई लेना देना नहीं है. वो सिर्फ दो ही चीज देखते हैं, आपका स्केल क्या है. आप आज 500 लोगों को सर्व करने की ताकत रखते हो, हेलमेट आपने दिया 10 लोगों को, 5000 को देके देखिए, फिर वापस से खींच के देखिए, कितने लोग कहते हैं सर मैं पे कर दूंगा लेकिन लो मत मुझसे हेलमेट. दैट्स कॉल्ड ट्रैक्शन, मार्केट ट्रैक्शन. यू नीड टू शो द ट्रैक्शन इन द मार्केट. यू कांट गो बैक विद द PPTs एंड स्लाइड्स एंड देन से I have built this phenomenal model which will work this way. This is my business calculation. This is my business plan. And please fund me. I am so happy that you are funding me. I'll be obliged for my lifetime. No, it doesn't work that way. They are not here to oblige you. They are here to make money. And the money is very dirty, unfortunately. So money is going to be placed. Bank kisi ko paisa deta hai kya? Jiske paas paisa nahi ho. बैंक उसी को पैसा देता है जिसके पास उसकी कैपेसिटी टू पे बैक है. हमें और आपको पैसा मिलेगा क्या? अगर अंबानी के पास को पैसा चाहिए तो उसको आसानी से मिलेगा, हम लोगों को पैसा मिलेगा? अनफॉर्चुनेटली मनी ओनली गोज आफ्टर पीपल हु हैज मनी. आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम प्रोफेसर रवांदे. थैंक यू सर फॉर मेकिंग इट. Well, I had a different plan of sharing the PPT about mission and all that stuff. But Suraj ji showed a video which spoke about free money is available and anybody can, sell his company to Facebook. It's so easy. So I wanted to do a reality check that it's life and death. Please understand that. Money is not freely available because the moment you start getting that money, the investors are going to be after your... That's it. They don't even care about your business. They only know one thing. If you have taken my money, in 5 years I need to get this back. At a double. At least double. That's why if you see there are now companies, X to 10X. There was one gentleman who was sitting in my office just before this. D10X. Like, is this X to 10X kind of thing? Can you say, hum log technical feasibility analysis karte hain ki 10X kaise pahunchenge? Manika, please, that's the door. Manika, I've been into the tech industry for last two decades, and I'm still not able to figure out how to make that X to 10X kind of affair. Right? So please understand this, that it's a life and death game. Money is not free, because it's somebody else's money. It's somebody else's money, right? And it's not for charity. It's not for charity. If you want to create, if you want to see the valuation, what is it that you need to create first? Valuation versus value, right? You need to create value. That's why I say, come back with the proposal, with the refined thing that creates value. Never try to think, क्योंकि कोई भी ऐसा आज तक आदमी नहीं मिला मेरे को जो कह साहब मेरा ऐसा ब्रिलियंट आइडिया है, वर्ल्ड चेंजिंग आइडिया है, ये पूरा मार्स को बदल देगा, दुनिया को बदल देगा. But it's not about idea. It's about the series of idea. See, nobody can say that this is one idea. Do you think Windows operating system was created because people or someone originally thought about creating an operating system? What was he trying to do? He was trying to build a calculator to solve a simple thing. But idea after idea led to creating some of these things. People talk about Steve Jobs, right? I mean, there were a lot of mentions about Steve Jobs. Does anybody know who was the technical guy with Steve Jobs? Steve Woz, right? So Steve Wozniak. So there has to be someone who has to work, get his asses off, and still take that in his stride, that they were out of this whole world, only few people should know me. Nobody should know me. If you have that courage, that I want to make the world a better place without making sure that people know me, people should only see your impact. And then few of people in the gathering should say, I know that person. There are a lot of challenges, but it's all about timing, and the time is good for India, because the world over, it's all negative interest rate. Log agar apna paisa bank mein bhi dalenge, to unko paisa unka 5 saal baad wo nahi milega jinhone jama kiya tha. The world is reeling at a negative interest rate. So the money is going to follow India. The only thing, yesterday we were with Japanese delegation. They were talking about, they have tons and tons of grants to be given out to students. Please send them. At the end of it, I only said one thing. Because you have two things, great things. Paisa aapke paas bahut hai, aur boodhe log aapke paas bahut hai. Hamare paas jawan hai, paisa nahi hai, kaam nahi hai. Aap paisa dijiye, aapka bhala hoga, is desh ka bhala hoga. Right? So I think we have that much time. Otherwise, I am located at one of the corners of this campus, Atal Incubation Center, where there was the maximum impact of flood. We were all underwater. We are still trying to come up with our, with our neck up afloat, and we are trying to rebuild that whole thing. Please drop in for a coffee, and we would like to interact, speak more about it. The journey is very tough, and I will just leave with one few lines. Ki manzile milengi bhatak kar hi sahi. There are very challenge, a lot of challenge, right? So manzile milengi bhatak kar hi sahi, gumrah to wo hai jo ghar se nikle hi nahi. So please walk over, it's not very far from here. Please drop in for a cup of coffee. Let's hash it out. All those people, naysayers who say that India is a great place to do startup, free money is available, please do a reality check with me there. Thank you.
Thank you very much for this informative session, sir. I would like to request you to take the seat. I would also like to request Principal Dr. Kishore Ravande, sir, to join us on the stage. Oh. I would like to request Dr. Kishore Ravande, sir, to felicitate Dr. Mohit Dubeji. So we are here to this valedictory function on this 3-day national workshop on intellectual property rights. So we are very lucky to have our principal sir here. We are going to begin with this valedictory function with the award that we are going to give to some groups. We had around six to seven groups who had presentations, and Suraj sir is going to talk more about it. So I would like to request Suraj sir.
So as discussed earlier, we will be having voting round, right? So power warriors, where is power? Please stand up. So those who like their presentation, please raise your hand.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay. Right. Then Sush, please stand up. Those who like Sush presentation. Okay, more than Power Warriors. Theek hai. Thank you. Then Fitbit. Even more than previous one. Great. Theek hai. So you are in the race now. Then Phoenix.
1, 2, 3.
Okay. Then out of the blue, those who like their presentation and idea, please raise your hands. Okay, very few. And then last is Vita Foodie. So those who like their presentation because they have done it nicely. Okay. And Mindbenders. Okay. So as everyone guessed, so Fitbit is on the lead. So let's have a big round of applause for Fitbit. And can we have Team Fitbit on the stage?
Yeah, so I would like to request Dr. Mohit Dubeji and Kishore Ravande sir to give away the award to all the students for their wonderful performance on the presentation on LP generation. Can we have a huge round of applause for all the students? Yes, sir. Keep clapping. You have to encourage all these students. Right, I would like to request all these members to come forward for a group photo. Thank you. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very sure that you all have enjoyed this program very much. So how many of you really enjoyed this three-day workshop? I'm very sure that all of you enjoyed it. So can you just give a huge round of applause for this wonderful program? And we are looking forward to have such more programs in the future. Now, we'll proceed, and I would like to request some of you to come forward and give your opinions and views about this program, your experiences. Please come forward and share your experiences. Huzaif, who's Huzaif? Yeah, please come forward.
Yeah. Good evening, everyone. It's good evening. Good evening, everyone. I am Huzaif Mujawa here. I am from Bharati Vidyapeth. And I was very fortunate enough. I'm actually here with one of my most students, Shravani Tonge. We two people are here from Bharati Vidyapeth. And we are very fortunate enough that we got to get this opportunity to come here and attend this three-day program. And to be very honest with you, I feel very privileged and lucky, even though like it would be very tiring for us. But it was worth it. I would definitely say it was worth it. To travel this much and come all the way here to attend this program, it was definitely worth it. The time slot also, like from 9 to 5:30 for an engineering student to attend at one workshop, it's not possible. It's not that easy to make him sit at one place and make him attend a 9 to 5. Like, it's not easy for a job even. And that to a workshop, the first thing that comes is, kitne jaldi yahan se nikal sakte. But like, to be very honest with everyone, all the faculties of MIT, I'm really grateful. It was well organized, and I really thoroughly enjoyed each and every session done by Divya ma'am and everyone present over here, all the committee, organizing committee present over here. Thank you so much. Thank you for giving us such a wonderful opportunity.
Thank you very much. Now I would like to request Professor Sarang to come here and share his experience. Professor Sarang.
Good evening, everyone. First, I would like to thanks all faculties of MIT who take initiative and organize such wonderful event. Also, I would like to thank CPAM team for such wonderful event. And whatever the schedule of program was nice and well organized by all. Thank you.
Thank you. Can we have Mrs. Jacob? Mrs. Jacob.
Good evening, everyone. First of all, I must thank everybody, like main organizing committee of this program. This is what I was seeking. Like, all these queries were in my mind, but I was not able to get answers through Google. So I must say, whatever information we got through CPAM members and other private company members, it was really very helpful. And I must say ki, the program was very well organized. And thanks to everyone.
Thank you. Can we have Abbas?
Hey guys, good evening. First of all, can we have a huge round of applause for Sarang sir, Stephen, and all the organizers, because they worked day and night for this event to come possible. So intellect is a word which can't be materialized. And to protect that word is an entire other ball game. So learning about intellectual property rights and, you know, legalizing it, protecting our work against trollers and other people who really just are for the profit and are not for respecting the individual's work. So this intellectual property rights seminar gave me a lot of information regarding protecting my work, my design, my literature, and my application or my ideas. So if not for this seminar, I would have gone to other places and I wouldn't have got the complete knowledge. So Divya Man, Sarangsan, all the organizers gave us such knowledge from all industrial professionals that we could actually get to know what is happening at this moment in the industry of intellectual property rights and the legal matters. So thanks a lot, sir, and thanks, Stephen, everyone, for organizing this event. And thank you, guys.
All right. Can we have Mr. Vivek Jagtap?
Hello, guys. My name is Vivek. First of all, I thank MIT for arranging such good program. Basically, I'm a chartered accountancy student, and I'm into my CA finals, and also pursuing law from Yashwant Rao Chavan Law College, Pune, second year. This IPR thing really fascinated me because I am into traditional CA practice, filing IT returns, GST returns, tax audits and all. But this is the next big thing, and so I just happened to click on Facebook and then entered the Google Forms. But this is really good. But what I expected more is of a practical insight into actual filing of patents and registrations. So I would love if you have any other session henceforth. Thank you.
Thank you. Mahajan ma'am.
Good evening to one and all. Actually, first, I would like to thank you, whole MIT team, Mr. Boyer, sir, and Mr. Pawar, sir, who has given me the opportunity to attend this workshop. After that, I would really like the way I'm attending a various workshop in various places. But among that, I really like the way you have conducted, because I feel it's an activity-based workshop. It's the first workshop I have attended, but I really like the way and everything, the speaker and the hospitality and everything is very, very well. Thank you so much for the wonderful opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Now it's time for the thing that you all have been waiting for. That is, correct, certificates. So I would like to request Dr. Mohit Dubey sir and Dr. Kishore Ravande sir to give away the certificates. Professor Dipti Chaudhary. Manan Gaur. Round of applause. Amir Deshmukh, go. Vandana Nautiyal. Sarang Hole. Shweta Raichurkar. Aditya Mane. Angela Jacob. Gauri Athavale. Do we have Gauri Athavale? Who's if? Shravani Tonge. Round of applause, everyone. Shruta Kirti Mahajan. Riti Kukreja. Raut Rohan Rajpal. Abbas Vivek Jagtap keep clapping guys, you must not stop.
Okay, Ayush Bohra. Rainer. Pranay Ingle. Kaustubh. Devram Bhimram Sutar. Right, thank you so much. Thank you, sir. Now I would like to request Dr. Kishore Avande, sir, to address the gathering.
Good evening, friends. I'm not going to speak long. I know we are at the fag end of this wonderful three-day workshop. My esteemed colleague, Dr. Mohit Dubey, Suraj Boyer, Mohandas Pawar, Swapnil, and my student friends, other colleagues from MIT University, distinguished participants. I am indeed delighted, extremely happy to see such a wonderful feedback. We had 4-5 speakers talking so good about what has happened over the last 3 years. I was really not fortunate like any one of you here to have attended these sessions. I was told the sessions that were conducted by Divya and others were extremely useful and very, very beneficial to all young minds here sitting here who would be creating the intellectual property in their career ahead. And probably some of you are also already engaged in the process. And I was fortunate to be a little early to hear a few words of Dr. Mohit Dubey. He is extremely excellent orator, speaker, and he always ends up in a Hindi couplet which sums up what all he said. And he said very well about somebody who has not at all come out of the house. He's already lost himself. So I think he talks so wonderfully. He conveys the message so well. And we at MIT ADT University is really fortunate to have a person like Mohit Dubey, who is heading the Atal Incubation Center. And I think he has already told you about this mission, about Atal Incubation Center and what it would do. I was also talking to our students at MIT School of Engineering a few days before when we had poster competitions. And there I said each batch of the students that the purpose of poster competition or presenting an idea was whether it is through poster or whether it is through an essay writing competition or whatever it is not just restricted to a kind of a celebration of an event, let us say Engineers Day. Do something on that day, some of you will get the prize, you receive the prize, and that's the end of it. It is something beyond that, is that you are encouraged to think, imagine ideas, and then put them before the people who visit those posters. And then obviously when you have an interaction with the people there, your ideas would start getting flourishing. It would get a lot of boost, and you will be able to do something better. And finally, at the end of several poster presentations, several ideas that float around, discussed around, probably some of you will come out with some concrete ideas which can find a place in Atal Incubation Center. And all of you know what it would do for that. So it's really a wonderful thing. I must thank my colleague Suraj Boyer, Mohandas Pawar, who has taken initiative of conducting this workshop on IPR. It was supported by Government of India, the ministries there, Commerce Ministry, etc. I think we were very lucky to have these support that is coming from the New Delhi. And as well known, Suraj Boyer is a dynamic leader. He knows how to connect people. So in a very short time, he got this idea of conducting the workshop on IPR materialized. And he got really about 100 participants to participate in this. Believe me that when I was young like you, or probably when I joined my teaching profession and then started doing research, my research scholars actually did really a very, very wonderful work in the area of what you call the carbon neutral construction blocks, building blocks. But believe me, this was done about 15 years ago when we were not talking much about patents and IPR, et cetera, et cetera. Off late for last decade, I think we are talking more about IPR, protecting intellectual property right. And believe me, that work was extremely, I mean, it was patentable work, but we in a hurry of telling the people that, look, we have done something great work in terms of developing a carbon neutral blocks, which was a soil cement fly ash blocks. And we really did a really good work. My research scholar did good work. But in a haste, we actually published paper. And once you publish paper, the filing patent would be a difficult time. There are some norms, etc. You must have already learned about how this filing of patent is done, what are the processes, what are the various formalities involved. But what I'm trying to share with you, at that time, probably our knowledge in the area of filing patents or what patent means was really not adequate enough, and really we did not understand. And we filed a, we published a paper, and then later we realized that this is a patentable work which should have, which for which we should not have been published a paper. So anyway, those were the days. Of late last 15 years, the technology, the way it is happening, and the way things are happening. In fact, morning technology doesn't exist in the evening, and it's so rapid changes that are happening in the technology. All of you are really fortunate enough, born post what you call, you know, you have smartphones, you have laptops, you have Google uncle helping you all the time, but we were not there. When I did my PhD, I was hardly having any, in fact, can you believe that there was no Microsoft Office, there was nothing like that. I was working on 286 processor. That was the computer that I used, first generation computer. So all of you are really fortunate, you are blessed with the technology that is available around. The only thing is, these technologies have to be channelized well, it has to be used for the benefit of society, for constructive purposes, etc., etc. Anyway, I must thank on behalf of being a dean of research and consultancy as well, I must thank all of you that our effort of putting this workshop in place for the benefit of all of you has been utilized well. I assure you that more such things will come for you. Somebody was mentioning about the whole process of filing the patent was expected. Probably certain things which have not been deliberated or presented for you during these 3 days. In the feedback, I think we will take what is required further for all of you. Besides this, we will also do more of you know, activities which is research related, which is IPR related, for the benefit of not only MIT DT students, but for the students of, not only students, but all those who are associated with technology, development of intellectual property, etc., etc. And MIT ADT management per se encourages us to do all this for the community at large. So I, on behalf of management, assure you that we will give you more and more such workshops, conferences, seminars in the years to come, in the days to come. I must also share with you that we have a big event in the December 18 to 20, which is what we call the, it's a conference on seven tracks. There are IVF conference that is being held in association with the French universities. It's a very big event. There are 4 Nobel laureates who are visiting and who are delivering lectures in that. The details are available on website. All of you are really invited to browse that website, look at that, participate as a delegate, participate as an author delegate, and enjoy that workshop. That's going to be a mega event that will be happening in December at this MIT DT University campus. With this, I must once again thank all of you for having responded and stayed here till the last, and I hope you have enjoyed that. Once again, my thanks. I must say that all these claps go to all these organizers who have been toiling hard for the last 3 days plus few days before that. They deserve claps. Sujit has been doing wonderful work. Mohandas Pawar is here. think Swapnil and students who have also volunteered to help the organization of whole event. So thank you everybody, and have a good time. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. There is one announcement for all the participants that the participants who haven't got the certificates, they can collect their certificates outside. Now the program is not yet over. I would like to request Professor Mohan Pawar sir to propose the vote of thanks. He is the co-convener of this program. A huge round of applause for Professor Mohan Pawar.
Mind is the most powerful weapon on the earth, above the earth, and under the earth, and it is only possible got through the education. On behalf of the research and consultancy cell, MIT ADT University, I, Professor Mohan Pawar, from MIT School of Engineering, deem it a great honor and privilege to stand before you to deliver the vote of thanks. At first, I wish to express my gratitude to our founding father, Honorable Professor Vishwanath Karat sir, whose blessings are always with us. I also extend my thanks to our driving force, Professor Dr. Mangesh Karat sir, Executive President, MIT ADT University, and our Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sunil Rai, who always encourages us for organizing this activity. I also wish to express my gratitude to Dr. Mohit Dubey, CEO, Atal Incubation Center, MIT ADT University. I also wish to express my gratitude to a program chairperson, Dr. Kishore Ravande sir, to help to make it possible for execution of this workshop. I also wish to express my gratitude to Professor Suraj Boyer, convener of this IPR workshop, who has created an opportunity of this IPR workshop. I may like to express my sincere thanks for giving the support by CPAM, Minister of Commerce, Industry, Government of India. I also thankful for association provided by Atal Incubation Center, MIT ADT Incubator Forum. I also extend my thanks to all the speakers for creating interest and inspired all the participants from Ketan & Co, Jahangir, Gulabai, Bila Moria, Daruwala, Photon Legal. I also wish to express my gratitude to all the comparing committee, Professor Swapnil Shirsat sir, Shreya, Sudeshna, Vaishnav, Soumya. I also wish to express my gratitude to all the organizing committee, advisory board, invitation and registration committee, licensing team, hospitality and food management, resource mobilization team, technical support, Mr. Nagesh sir, media and photography team, Vikas sir, and ISBJ students. Last but not the least, I thank all the participants for motivating us by attending all the sessions and showing their interest in this workshop. Once again, thank you very much to all who assemble here. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now, we are towards the end of the program. May I request you all to rise in your seats for the national anthem.
अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मागे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
भारत माता की
जय
भारत माता की
जय
थैंक यू